Greetings, saints, and grace to you from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. I'm Pastor Billy D., and welcome to today's Moments in Ministry. What is your calling? We read of it in 1 Corinthians 7 and 20, where it says each one should remain in the condition in which he was called. Some people have the foolish notion that the only way in which they can live for God is by becoming pastors, missionaries, or Bible teachers. How many would be excluded from the opportunity of spiritual usefulness if this were the case? Beloved, it is not office, it is sincerity. It is not position, it is grace that will enable us to serve and glorify God. God is definitely glorified at the workbench, where the godly worker fulfills his task, singing of the Savior's love. In this humble setting, God is glorified far more than in many a lofty pulpit, where official religion performs its scanty duties. The name of Jesus is glorified by the taxicab driver as he blesses God. He will be more useful than the popular preacher who gives about peddling the gospel for profit. God is glorified when we serve him in our proper vocations. Take care, dear Christian, that you do not neglect the path of your duty by leaving your occupation. Do not dishonor your profession while in it. Think little of yourselves, but do not think too little of your callings. Every lawful trade may be sanctified by the gospel to noblest ends. Turn to the Bible, and you will find the most menial forms of labor connected either with most daring deeds of faith or with persons whose lives have been illustrations of holiness. Therefore, do not be discontented with your calling. Whatever God has made your position or your work, remain in that unless you are quite sure that he calls you to do something else. Let your first concern be to the glory of God. To the best of your ability, where you are, fill your present sphere to his praise, and if he needs you in another, he will show it to you. This day, lay aside anxious ambition and embrace peaceful content. Here's a slice of today's bread of heaven from Ephesians 1, 6 and 7. To the praise of the glory of his grace, wherein he hath made us accepted in the Beloved, in whom we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of sins according to the riches of his grace. Let us pray. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemy. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. So until we come this way again, may God bless you and keep you, is my prayer.